come into cat cow, come into cat cow. Hands are directly underneath your shoulders. Shoulder width apart. Knees are hip distance apart. Everything's at right angles.
Inhale, eyes are open. Inhale, eyes are open. Head up, stomach down.
And then exhale, head down, stomach up.
Inhale, head up, stomach down.
Exhale, head down,
stomach up. Look up, look up.
Very good.
Look up, yes.
Excellent. Just arch your back completely like a cat and then like a cow.
Excellent for your entire spinal cord, for your spinal health, very good for your nervous system, very good for your digestive system.
Excellent exercise to be done every day as well, one that yoga recommends to be included in a daily practice.
Again, don't overdo it. Take a break when you need to. Take a break when you need to.
All 72,000 nerve junctions that connect to the Sushumna and the energetic body, all those nadis, all those junctions are being worked on. All those junctions are being refined to assist in better flow of energy in that energetic body. 10 more seconds. And come back to center, come back to center. Sit again with your legs off. Let's continue. Jump right into the next one. Jump right into the next one. Interlace your fingers. Pull your hands away from your lower back. So have a good stretch in your chest region. Good stretch in your chest region. Good stretch in your shoulders, feel a good stretch in your arms. Inhale left, exhale right. Twist. Try and pull your hands away from your lower back as far as it's comfortable. To create a good stretch in your upper arms, good stretch in your deltoids, good stretch in your chest region. Works in your anahat chakra. Very good, inhale left. Exhale right, of course very good for your spine, very good for your waistline as well. This exercise also stimulates Kundalini in the Muladhara chakra, in the base chakra. Ten more seconds. And come back to center. Immediately bring your hands to your knees. Hold on to your knees. Inhale, left shoulder up. Exhale, right shoulder up. Inhale, left shoulder up. Exhale, right shoulder up. And go. Left shoulder up, right shoulder up. Very good. Hard to reach muscles. We're going to get to them. Places where you tend to store stress and tensions. We're going to help dissolve that. We're going to help dissolve that. Find a good rhythm. Don't give up on the first sign of discomfort. See it through, keep going, see it through. It'll open up, it'll get easier. Right here, 15 more seconds. Excellent, excellent. And come back to center.
Open your mouth slightly in a half yawn and roll your neck around in a big circle. Roll your neck around in a big circle. Feel uncomfortable dropping it back, don't do so. Just go in a big circle. Attack points of tension, knots, stresses. Work those areas, massage them. Have your mouth half open as if in a yawn, but you breathe in through the nose. Really relax all those muscles there. Relax all those muscles there. Go the other way, reverse direction, reverse direction. Work them the other way. We always try and do our yoga exercises to promote balance. So we always try and do counter directions and counter poses to ensure we don't create imbalances. The sets are designed as such as well. The sets are designed with that in mind. Amongst other design components, that's one of the important ones. And come back to center and just relax for a few moments. Nice and tall. You might find your breath altogether disappears. That's all right if it happens automatically. You realize your breath is not even needed. The great stillness of the mind occurs. It correlates with great stillness of the breath as well. You'll naturally come to these states and these stages. It all happens on its own, it's a blossoming. Relaxation period is very important. We did a whole set of exercises. Now we let the body take advantage of all that energy we've generated. We'll jump into our Kriya next. Again, don't overdo it. I want to just give a heads up. Take breaks when you need to. Some of these postures I'll offer modifications for. Please use them. Pace yourself. Come out of the posture anytime you feel it's too much. You can sit cross-legged. You can lie down. You can just take a break and rejoin us again. Same thing with the breath that's accompanying the postures. This breath of fire and you're feeling dizzy, come out of it. Switch to long, deep breathing first. Even if that's too much, just switch to normal breathing. You have every right to govern your pace in this class. Use the modified bow pose. In modified bow pose, just pull your heels into your buttocks. In modified bow pose, just pull your heels into your buttocks. If you can, raise your upper body and your thighs off the ground. Raise your upper body and thighs off the ground if you can, holding your ankles. Otherwise, just pull your ankles firmly into your buttocks. Now from bow pose, those who can, rock in bow pose. Inhale forward, exhale back. Bow pose is another excellent exercise you should try and do every day. It's for youth and optimum health. Youth and optimum health. Rocking in bow pose is to keep you young forever.
Again, don't overdo it. Just do the best you can. 10 more seconds. 10 more seconds. And come out of it.